Welcome back to my channel. I hope you guys are doing well. So in today's video, we're going to be doing this pumpkin jack-o'-lantern. Is it called a jack-o'-lantern? I'm not too sure. But we're going to be doing this tutorial. First things first, I'm going to attempt to lay down my eyebrows. And the reason why this is not a talk-through video is because it was really hot and I had my fan on. So yeah, you guys know we've had that really hot situation going on, that heat wave. So I am just going to use the Got to Be Glued gel and just flatten my eyebrows. I think you could probably do with two layers of this as opposed to one. I just did one and I think I probably should have done two. And then I'm gonna go in with my Coty air sponge, just pack on that powder onto the brows, and then I'm gonna go in with this orange color corrector from LA Girl. And I'm just going to blend that onto my eyebrows using a sponge. You guys can see my eyebrows do peek through a bit, but I'm learning how to block my brows, you guys. It's a work in process, especially because I have such bushy eyebrows. So I would definitely say use two layers of the Got to Be Glued gel and also use a concealer to just, you know, cancel out that underneath color of the eyebrow that can sometimes peek through certain products. So then I'm gonna go in with the orange foundation color adjusting product from LA Girl. You guys can see it's super orange. And then I'm also gonna be taking this Beauty Co pigment. I think this is in the number 10. And I'm going to be setting my entire face with this. You can see it looks more true to color, more orange like a pumpkin when setting the face with this. Then I'm going to be taking my Hebe Beauty, this is the Ultimate Eyeliner Pencil, the Ultimate Kajal Eyeliner Pencil in black, and I'm just going to be using this to line my waterline, just cancel out most of that eye color, and draw the triangles for the pumpkin eyes. So just following a general triangle shape. This is a pretty simple tutorial, I think. I used very little products as well, so I feel like it is definitely beginner friendly. I'm also drawing a triangle on my nose. The mirror is blocking, I do apologize. Next, I'm going to be taking my Switch Beauty Holy Grail Flash Case, and I'm going to be coloring in these blocks with that cream product. And I just decided to show you guys what it looked like in this frame because I forgot to show it before I started coloring in my face. Just making sure I stay within the lines of the pencil. And then I'm going to be taking this black eyeshadow. Now this is from the Switch Beauty Unicorn Sauce palette. So I'm just using any black eyeshadow to just set that cream product into place. It really doesn't matter what brand it is or what palette it is. The Unicorn Sauce palette is discontinued, but I feel like I still keep that palette for Halloween looks and really colorful looks as well. Then I'm taking my Revlon So Fierce mascara and I'm going to add mascara to my top and bottom lashes just to cancel out all that natural color and make it all look black. I also took my Dani Cosmetics liquid lipstick. It is a true black liquid lipstick. And I just put that on my lips because I find the super creamy products don't last very long on my lips. And then I'm taking the Holy Grail Flash Case again with a brush and just drawing the type of outline of the mouth. And then doing the top first, kind of giving myself a guideline on the sides of the mouth. And then just sort of drawing that square pattern. You can also do the jagged pattern. I think that's a little bit more tricky. But yeah, I decided to go for this square type of pattern, which I think is quite traditional in most pumpkin heads or pumpkin carving rather. So I'm just filling that in. And then I'm also going to be taking the black eyeshadow once again and setting everything into place. The Switch Beauty Holy Grail Flash Case is very creamy, so I would highly recommend you using the same color eyeshadow to just set all of that into place. Next, I'm going to go in with that exact same black eyeshadow and a blending brush, and I'm basically going to use this to draw like those distinct lines you get on a pumpkin. So I'm drawing it all the way from the top of my temple, or top of my head rather, all the way to my jawline. And you guys will see towards the end of the video, I do go in and I also add some foundation on my neck area. You can add foundation or like this specific orange color correcting foundation situation as far down on your chest area as you would like. I just decided to go just down my neck because I was going to remove this afterwards. But I wanted to give you guys the full pumpkin experience. So as you guys can see, I'm just kind of doing slightly curved lines along the face, making sure I follow that through all the way through the pumpkin. And as you guys can see now, I'm just going in and setting the neck area. I've already gone in with that orange foundation and just setting it with that neon powder, and then drawing the distinct pumpkin type of lines. And that is it for this pumpkin jack-o'-lantern Halloween makeup look. It's super easy, super simple, and you guys can definitely recreate it at home. Thank you guys so much for watching. I love you guys so much, and I'll talk to you in the next one. Bye bye.